Let me start the second talk as part of the one series of works. We're working on multi-beam or switchable beam antenna systems, which will be employed by satellites, aircraft, or other applications. Definitely 5G handheld devices might include the type of antennas we are going to propose to you. The second talk is entitled Planar Multi-Beam Metamaterial Antenna on a Drone. Simply speaking, this is the connection of a metamaterial antenna, which has seen the development or improvement from other metamaterial stuff, connected to a drone system. So drone, in line with the projects of a satellite development, we need something lighter, or we should comply with the specifications on weights, mass, or volumes. So to make our antennas or millimeter or RF components adopted by the satellite or some cube systems, actually we need small but smart antennas. So here we introduce the metamaterial technologies that give us the advantages in terms of design or in terms of the progressive work for the next possible solutions. Yeah, here I introduce the names of the authors, co-authors, who have given me instrumental help to from the standpoint of the design to system work. I'll skip this. You can read the list of the authors' names. Yeah, the outline starts with the brief introduction, what we are going to, kind of just a direction setting. It is followed by the technological trend under the name of UAV, drone, UAM, UAS, or whatnot. And that keeps a company, keeps a company with antennas and the feeding circuits, which make the radiation possible. Without the feeding structure or feeding circuits, antennas will play the role of the zombies. So here we need the feeding circuits. And the summary and conclusions are waiting for these three important technological reviews and explanations. The brief introduction tells us the directions. What we are going to need is the small or light antennas, which are quite apt to the drone system or drone communication system. So drones have or UAVs, UAMs, as another name. The technology we propose here will be applicable to not only drones, but also bigger UAVs. But actually, don't be confused between the sizes or the purposes or the functions of the drones and UAVs. They are almost the same. And the second motivation is we need the high directive antennas. So here, as I already mentioned, the new antenna system, Vivaldi antenna array, which was attached to or attachable to the surface of the smaller satellites, such as LEO satellites, ENFIRE, Yagi UDA antenna, will be very useful. So we find it useful to be adapted for the drone systems. The reason is different from satellites, the body of a drone is quite curvy, different from the satellites, which have many faceted faces or multi-angled faces. Actually, drones employ the curved surfaces. So they're actually when making a curved antennas, it is difficult, but we can do, but it is quite costly. So to reduce cost to develop the antenna structures for the flying objects or vehicles, we prefer smaller antennas. Then we can building a structure by putting tiles. So smaller ones are quite giving us the lots of opportunities to extend our technology. So Yagi antenna is going to be adopted here, but it is not alone. That accompanies the circuit, such as power divider for feeding. So power divider, which is a radial power divider, which has many branches. Here we put the emphasis on the level of difficulty, difficulty in terms of design and implementation. So you are going to see how it works. And before tapping into the technological part, such as the theoretical and design aspects of antennas, we need to check the popularity of drones these days in the simple consumers industry, at the same time, a very special industry, such as military aircraft or others, or just a kind of surveillance or observation of the landscape movement or phenomena. So the trend is one drone is not enough. As you already have experienced the performance by drones make the just a symbol like this. On your right bottom, you can see a small, very blurry logo of Intel. So Intel has stepped into the field of drones because they developed the chipsets to control the movement of drones. So that was possible. At the same time, a fast manner, they should communicate with each other cooperatively, and they can avoid the collision between them and make form a specific curve or specific letter, things like that. And other people have approached the design of the drones by showing you there is an array of drones. They do not, they have a regular distance between them. So the regular distance is controlled by the chipsets and the controlling algorithm. So they can avoid collision. At the same time, they can make a group activity. Not only Professor Kumar's team, but also many people have tried to make the drone systems of UAV systems working together cooperatively. At the same time, they working on a specific mission to find something. This is going to be applied in the field of a synthetic aperture radar as soon as possible. A little bird tweeted to me, yeah, the communities, such as military communities, already have started the development of drones that can replace the conventional SAR systems, which can make the radar image of the Earth like that. And you also refer to the histograms that give us the idea. The industry is growing very fast. So the number you can refer to is the years. And by 2025, as you see, compared to the 55 you can see almost the four times or fourfold jump from the starting point of the observation of the trend to 202, like that. Or you can find other articles that describe how the industry evolves. The trend is, as you're already seeing in the previous picture, Kumar's or TED lecture, these a multiple or plural drones should keep the distance like a social distancing. They keep the distance according to the algorithm, which were already given or plotted into the chips. And then by keeping the distance, they can do many interesting jobs currently and for the future. So well, the reason my students have brought this picture is you can recognize how small the drone is. If you put yourself, maybe these drones are have very smaller profiles compared to you, not like a global hawk or very ferocious military unmanned vehicles. Actually, these can be used for delivering the packages or finding the directions for cars, such as a car path finding or routing problem solver, things like that. So these, each of these drones is very small. Then it is inevitable we need small antennas that are attachable to it. But as see, you can take a look at what the vertical sticks here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, five sticks. These five sticks are called top-loaded monopole antennas. Top-loaded monopole antennas can find the advantages or benefits, but simultaneously, you can find drawbacks or shortcomings in terms of the functions. So we would like to replace the top-loaded monopole, which can be easily broken or which can give you some kind of a nuisance or pet peeves, which is what wind pressure. When a drone tries to move fast, actually everything except the propellers is going to be a kind of obstacle in speeding. So we need very low profile antennas. People say these vertical top loaded monopoles are already small enough, but we were not satisfied with that. So we went on. So here, the planar structure, which can give the far field pattern or radiated field patterns to everywhere, we need the one unit antenna, which is going to be soon extended to array form. But array form antenna usually gives the concentrate the energy to one direction, but actually our purpose differs from what other people did already. Our antennas are going to be placed to what different angles. So almost no target will be missed by our antennas. But here, what we focus on the performance of the antenna as one unit element. Here, well, this is the starting point of the design. That's why I brought this. And the reflection coefficient tells us the frequency of interest or operation, 5.8 gigahertz, another drone operation frequency. And a far field pattern looks like this. So this antenna, this picture is the top view of the geometry. And this is the 3D view of the geometry along with the far field pattern. So here, we expect the far field pattern into this direction. And we developed the radial power divider, which is quite proper for the eight-directed far field pattern. So you cannot miss the target once you put this antenna on top of the monopole antenna. Monopole antenna, actually, as you see, the vertical structure, which has the omnidirectional far field pattern, this which far field pattern is also good for finding the direction of the target, but one direction, when the energy is distributed to all the area, the power level is going to be diminished. But instead, we have one direction with one antenna policy. This improves the function of the finding the object right in front of you when the drone is flying or hovering to find the object. This is power divider, which is going to be connected to the radiators as soon as possible. So this is the reflection coefficient of power. And this is the power division ratio of all these eight elements of the power divider. So one, two, three, clockwise, you can count the number of the terminals of the power divider. So this is the common input port, and this is the port one all the way through to output port number eight. So this is quite handy, but the level of design difficulty is very high compared to others. So this is the final form of the antenna. So radiating elements as Yagi Uda antennas or radiators are attached to the end or terminals of the power dividers. Then we have this far field pattern. This is top view, and this is the 3D view of the radiated field pattern of the antenna. This is top view of the structure. So this plate localized structure is going to be put on the drone. The frequency doesn't change that much. We can keep the frequency of operation at the same time with the far field patterns. You cannot miss the directions of things. And here you can experience the reduction of the power. You can add one more layer and it is skewed by one more angle than you can detect the reflected field from the objects you are trying to track. So this is a summary starting from the radiating element. And this is the final form, which doesn't miss the feeding structure like this. This is quite a new one. So so two technologies were combined together for taking advantages of the modern fabrication technologies, antenna technologies, and the drone technologies. Thank you.